everybody. Time to get into it. NBA action on 2K Sports. I'm Brian Anderson. Alongside Clark Kellogg and Grant Hill, Allie LaForce is our reporter. Allie, it's all yours.
Hey, Brian. This Sixers team is all in, Doc Rivers saying, quote, "We talked about it. We can do a lot of winning, or we can try to be the winner. And being a winner is hard. That's what we want to become. We want the opportunity to be the winner." Brian, there's a difference. Back to you.
Looking to be the last team standing, Allie. Thank you. Okay, a chance to look at some numbers for Javon Carter.
And currently, he's in the zone. A tremendous feel for the game. His assist numbers these past five games look a lot different from the rest of the season. And by different, I mean better.
Let's check out Milwaukee's starting lineup. Giannis and Lopez are the bigs. Javon Carter is out there with Drew Holiday. And it's Allen in at the small forward position. And for Philadelphia, up front, it's Tucker at the four, next to Embiid in the middle. Tyrese Maxey is out there with Matisse Thybulle. And it's Harris in at the three. It's early in the season, but we're already seeing some teams fall short of expectations. Grant, what do these teams need to do to get back on track?
Well, first of all, they have to relax. They can't panic. It's still early in the season. But, of course, it's on the leaders of each team to set the tone. They need to make sure everyone is locked in and on the same page.
Now here's Maxey. Pass to Thybulle. Just five on the clock. Here's Embiid. And a nice finish on the layup.
Showing off the superb handles for a seven-footer, Joel Embiid. Handles that thing tight.
Holiday passes to Antetokounmpo. And the foul is called. He missed it, so he's got a couple of free throws coming his way. That one on Tucker.
Everybody knows Giannis is elite. But just in case you have any doubt, he's got a trophy case you'd need almost the whole team to lift.
Drops a first. Well, Clark, Antetokounmpo's awards certainly do put him in some rare company.
Along with Jordan and Hakeem, the dream. B.A., I mean, Giannis is one of three players ever to win MVP, Finals MVP, and Defensive Player of the Year. Rarefied air indeed.
And so Antetokounmpo nails both of them. And Clark, looking at last year's Sixers team, they were last in the NBA in offensive rebounding.
And also last in field goal attempts. And those go hand in hand. If you're not taking a lot of shots, then you're not going to have a chance for a lot of offensive rebounds. That puts tremendous pressure on your offense when you're not getting second shots. I expect them to really emphasize crashing the offensive boards this season.
Now here's Maxey, averaging almost 23 points a contest. A fantastic offensive player. Antetokounmpo, the pass to Holiday. Outside Carter, lets the three fly, knocks it down from distance.
I tell you what, he clearly is one of the best players in the league who does not get the same kind of gas that other guys do. But there's no better all-around guard in the NBA than Drew Holiday.
Harris against Allen. Harris' shot is good.
Just taking it right to the rim, and no one was there to greet him.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Just over a minute and a half played here in this one. Holiday finds Antetokounmpo. Outside Carter. Pass to Holiday. Over to the left wing. Oh, and Giannis hammers it in.
Well, the aggressive approach from Giannis, I like it. Not settling for the layup, instead punching it on him. That's the way you do it.
For Philadelphia, they've gone 2 of 3 from the floor. Thybulle against Carter. Tucker with a screen on Carter. Here's Thybulle, rejected by Antetokounmpo. Here's Embiid. Perfect night so far, 2 for 2.
You know, Embiid, does most of his work inside, but he's pretty comfortable in the mid-range, too.
Here's Antetokounmpo. And let's see who is on top of the NBA when it comes to blocks. Number one, Brook Lopez.
He changes more shots than he blocks, and he blocks a ton of them.
No good on that one.
He's a nightly triple-double threat, and I think Giannis is the most unguardable player in the game.
He hits the second from the line. First quarter of ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Pass to Embiid. Allen against Harris. Stolen by Carter. To the paint. Oh, and Giannis hammers it in.
And that's what happens when you don't take care of the ball.
Hey, that makes the turnover hurt even more.
What, you mean the throwdown at the end? I'll tell you what, fellas, I mean, the highlight shows are going to pain them even more.
The Sixers trailing. Outside Maxi. About 3 minutes gone in the first quarter. Embiid a screen on Holiday. Here's Maxi. Oh, it's blocked by Lopez.
Lopez showing off the length there to get to that shot.
On the wing, Holiday, covered by Thybulle. Carter, the pass to Antetokounmpo. Outside Holiday, 5 on the clock. Down low. Fades. Unable to get that one. The 76ers go the other way with it. They faced off right here last time they met, but the home club just couldn't pull out the win.
And it was an entertaining game, but hard to win when you're inconsistent.
And in that game you mentioned, it was a great game. The reserves played a huge role.
Now here's Embiid. Last game, an incredible scoring display for him.
This is really amazing. I mean, from March 1st, 2014, to October 26, 2016, Joel Embiid didn't play in a basketball game. 31 long months, rehabbing back and foot injuries.
The free throw drops for Embiid. Well, give Philadelphia credit. They didn't rush Embiid back.
They, in fact, trusted the process, pun intended, folks. And Joel has returned the favor. An MVP caliber center who changes a franchise. He is a franchise cornerstone piece. A great example of how being patient and doing what's best for the player ends up being a winning combination for all.
And last season's scoring champion, Joel Embiid, the first center to lead the league in scoring since Big Shaq way back in the 2000 season.
Now here's Carter. An 11-point game for him in the win against Cleveland.
And he also contributed a couple blocks, too. Just a glimpse at the impact he had on defense.
Only one miss in the first 5 attempts, clearly feeling.
And the 76ers call time here. And Joel Embiid, last season, the first center to average over 30 a game since Moses Malone did it back in 1982, Grant.
Oh, B.A., talk about historic company. And how about this? Also the first ever international player to lead the NBA in scoring, too. I mean, he won't be the last with the way things are. third in steals.
And they are in the top five in fewest turnovers. They handle the rock with care, and that also helps you defensively, less chances for your opponents to run off a turnover.
And those high steal numbers, they usually can lead to some easy baskets. A live ball turnover allows teams to run. Outside Maxey. Pass to Harris. And they double up Harris. Thibel finds Tucker. Counted from distance.
Hey, one of the strongest part of Tucker's game is knocking down that three-point shot. He doesn't need much space to get it off.
Carter, the pass to Allen. Antetokounmpo against Tucker. And he finishes. That makes him 4 out of 5.
He's putting on a show this quarter, and the team's feeding off his energy.
Fantastic replay we just saw of the Mobile One drive.
And I love the way he played downhill on that drive. Love the attack mentality in a close game.
Maxey against Holiday. Harris left side. Antetokounmpo grabs the board. The Bucks have gone 5 of 6. They're rolling. Pass to Holiday. Back to Antetokounmpo. Over Harris. And Antetokounmpo the bucket on the assist from Holiday. Holiday's got 3 assists in the game. Harris, a screen on Holiday. Maxey passes to Tucker. Here's Harris. Checking the numbers, he's averaging close to 15 a game. Giannis with the rebound.
That's a shot he'd like back. He's usually going to make those.
Boy, the offense has been on point.
They have great timing and great communication. So hard to get stops against them.
Anytime they want, 24-7, give the ball to Holiday and just let him make a play.
Good from Holiday.
You know, in the case of Jrue Holiday, having two brothers in the league, I think, probably is added motivation for him to excel.
And the 76ers going with a whole new group out there. So he hits 1 of 2 from the stripe.
Montrezl Harrell can be so many things for this team. One of the best small ball fives in the NBA.
Back to Milton. Into the lane. Rejected by Antetokounmpo.
Well, you know, he's almost the perfect defensive player. He's got length and strength, and he's athletic. And Giannis plays the game hard all the time, too, which is impressive.
Another basket. He's now 6 for 7 in the contest. And a little more about Montrezl Harrell. What an addition he is to any roster, Clark.
I agree with you, B.A., whether he's starting or coming off the bench. Harrell brings great energy and production. A real injection as a spark plug.
Offensively, it's been a struggle for him.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
It's good.
Terrific design and execution, leading to an opportunity right at the rim.
Milton against Holiday. Connaughton outside. Pass to Nwora. Antetokounmpo outside. Clock at 4. The Bucks need to get up a shot here. Offensive rebound. He gets it. He's 7 for 8 and really going at him out there.
Getting out to a nice lead. Great flow and great execution.
Quality looks they're getting, and they're capitalizing on them, guys. They have to be happy with this start offensively.
Harrell. Again, Philadelphia.
Well, we don't see this often from Montrezl Harrell. That's a rare jumper for him, but it's right on the edge of his range, so he got it to go down.
Now here's Connaughton. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Here's Antetokounmpo. Ooh, Harrell with the denial. 7 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Holiday against Milton. Pass to Milton. Top of the key. That one's wide left. Antetokounmpo against Melton. Antetokounmpo inside. Oh, and makes it with the kiss. Antetokounmpo's got 19 points.
Once Giannis gets going now, he stays hot. He's capable of putting the entire offense on his broad shoulders.
And so it's the Milwaukee Bucks. They have a nice 9-point cushion at the end of the quarter, just pounding the painted area. That's helped them build an advantage. We'll be right back after this word. And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And a closer look here at the scoring breakdown for the Bucks.
Well, the big guys in the post are outworking their opponent in effort and physicality. They just simply want it more.
And, you know, in no time at all, they've also started finding points inside, already taking apart that interior defense.
And Milwaukee has possession. They lead by the biggest margin of the game at 9. Taking a look at the Bucks. We've got George Hill. Grayson Allen is out there with Bobby Portis. Then there's Pat Connaughton, and it's Lopez in at center. Misses off the right iron.
Well, it's a make-or-miss league. Sometimes the Jays just don't fall. It wasn't a bad shot.
Harris outside. Embiid against Lopez. So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting. That's on Brook Lopez. Well, Clark, you've got your good players in the league, but then there's that group that is in that elite category. What type of player commands that kind of respect?
Well, I think it's a guy who shows up every day but produces at a high level. I think you probably tip your hat to scores in that case, but there's a lot of respect and cachet given to outstanding defenders. Anybody that's excellent consistently, I think, gets a level of respect that's special.
And the first one at the line is good.
You know, what I respect about Embiid, in addition to his tremendous skill and size, is his willingness to keep working on himself. He's already an elite talent, but if he sees any room for improvement, he'll go to work to make it happen.
Tucker's checked in for Harrell. And Embiid drops them both. Milwaukee in the lead. And here's Allen. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Portis with a screen on Maxey. Here's Hill. Ooh, plenty of contact on that shot. Officials call the foul, and he'll take 2 free throws now.
Hill's experience on display there, doing a nice job handling the physical contact and drawing the foul.
First one falls for him. That's also good, so he hits both free throws.
He's as solid as it gets from the line. I mean, give him the opportunity, he's cashing in on those.
Embiid, a screen on Connaughton. Melton passes to Embiid. And he lays it up and in. Embiid's got 4 points now in the quarter.
He's just too big, too powerful, too skilled. Not worried about whoever's defending him at all.
Here in the second quarter, a little over a minute of play. Connaughton outside. Here's Hill. Pass to Allen. Takes a three. Philadelphia grabs the miss. They defeated Utah in their last game.
It was a lockdown effort defensively, contesting shots and really protecting the painted area.
Boy, I tell you what, I think you got to really appreciate the grit. Getting dirty, staying engaged. That's really what defense is all about.
Tucker. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, hard to corral the energy that P.J. Tucker plays with, and he gets in there and mixes it up, and he'll go to the line.
First free throw is good.
Boy, if you had the word grinder in the dictionary, P.J. Tucker might be right next to it. His energy and effort and selflessness, contagious.
And the 76ers making a change here. Thybulle's checked in. Ibaka, he's checked in for the Bucks. Matthews comes in for Connaughton. Good on both.
And give them credit for making a more concerted effort to get to the line this quarter.
Yeah, I like everything you said there, because when all else fails, if you can get to the stripe, that's really a good way to change the momentum in the game, because you get points and you also slow down the opponent, because the game isn't going up and down as much.
The Sixers trailing. Harris finds Thybulle. Pass to Maxey. Embiid, a screen on Hill. Oh, it's blocked by Lopez. That one's good for two. Quarter two and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. And let's swing it over to the sideline and hear from Allie.
Brian, Sixers head coach Doc Rivers earned the nickname Doc back in college for wearing a t-shirt with Julius Erving on it. In the NBA, he said, quote, "The first game I started was against the Sixers. I went over and said, Dr. J, how are you? And he said, Doc, how are you? I said, no, I'm Glenn. But he said, no, you're Doc. And that made me feel like $1 million. Guys.
All right, thanks, Allie.
Well, he was born in Arizona. When it's time for national team play, Matisse Thybulle suits up for Australia down under, the team he meddled with in 2020.
The 76ers have gotten 3 of 4 field goals in the second quarter. And that misses. That would have put them up. Milwaukee has gone 0 for 2 from outside in the second quarter. Pass to Hill. Now here's Allen, looking to end the drought. Milwaukee, no good that time either. Hey, it's fun to see NBA players like Thybulle go their own way for national competition.
Yeah, it is, B.A. I mean, that's part of the interesting fabric of the global nature of the game, particularly as it relates to the NBA. International tournaments are kind of like an alternate world, if you will. Guys who are NBA rivals end up being teammates, or their teammates wind up on the other bench. It's actually pretty cool to see.
Carter, he's checked in for the Bucks.
There's a lot to like about Tobias Harris, his comportment, his versatility. He's adaptable. I think that stands out as well. I mean, he's had to play a lot of roles on different teams, and he's done them all at a high level.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. And the 76ers making a change here. House has checked in. Here's a look at the teams that have been aggressive at attacking the glass this year, with the real stats, real scores from the real NBA. Number one, Milwaukee.
And I love how active they all are on the glass. When a shot goes up, this team takes a gang rebounding approach to tracking down their boards.
Carter, the pass to Allen. Closing in on 4 minutes played here in the second quarter. Lopez, a screen on Maxey. Carter with it, picked up by Embiid. And Embiid with the block. And that'll be Milwaukee's ball as it goes out of bounds. Bucks able to keep the possession. And what a phenomenal replay of that impressive rejection.
What a powerful rejection. He's not wanting them to get an advantage in this competitive game.
Five to shoot. Carter on the wing. Will it go?
They might want to get away from the three-point shot. It's really been dragging them down.
Pass to Tucker. Here's Thybul. Embiid inside. Again gets it to go. He can't miss. 5 for 5.
And why go away from attacking inside if the D has no answer for you?
Boy, they'd love if anyone could get a bucket.
Yeah, their offense has been grinding to a halt.
And here's Allen. The three. He drops it from range. Allen's got his first 3 points of the game.
Matthews has a nice feel, guys, for when a teammate has a clean look, gets him the ball.
The Sixers leading. Maxey with it. He had an 18-point outing in their last game against Utah.
And he brought the defense, secured 4 steals over the course of the game. And you know, in this quarter, they've really brought up their shooting percentage.
Anytime your field goal percentage is in the high 50s, partner, you're doing something right.
Now here's Lopez. A 29-point game for him in the win against Cleveland.
A pest down low. Those 3 blocks really affected guys attacking the hoop.
Boy, just cannot buy a bucket, guys. And tell you what, that's a painful quarter for him, and it's painful for me to watch, too.
Here's Maxey. And denied. He sends it right off the glass. Carter, the pass to Allen. Here's Matthews. No! They're unable to get the tying basket there. Here's House. Drops in the layup for two. And now it's a 5-point 76ers lead.
And now almost all their points coming from the paint.
The Bucks shooting pretty well at 45%. Pass to Matthews. Here's Lopez. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take 2 from the free throw line. That's on Joel Embiid.
The up fake from Lopez working to perfection.
And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the 76ers.
Well, they found their offensive openings in the mid-range, and they continue to find ways to open up those jump shot opportunities.
I also like the way they've been able to penetrate. The penetration has led to some big buckets as a result.
And a new group getting ready for the Sixers. Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Joel Embiid. Niang comes in for Tucker. Korkmaz is checked in for Thybul. And Milton subbed in for Maxey. And he makes both free throws.
They found their rhythm at the free throw line this quarter, trying to make up ground.
Here's Korkmaz. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. Three-pointer, no good. The Bucks trail. Carter on the wing. Jacks up a three. That shot missing. So Philadelphia will take it the other way. Pass to Niang. Now here's Milton. Here's Harrell. Antetokounmpo covering. Oh, and he blocks it off the glass. Wow. 1:31 left to play in the first half. Here's Nora. Here's Lopez. The nine-footer's on the mark. Lopez has got 4 points now in the quarter. For Philadelphia, they've gotten 7 of 12 shots to go here in the second. Now here's Milton. A minute 4 left in the first half of this one. And they pick up 2. So it's Milwaukee now. Antetokounmpo, left side. And Antetokounmpo with the stuff.
I just love the aggressive finish.
I'm thinking he's sending a strong message with that jam.
That's exactly how you send it. Two hands and down.
Here's Korkmaz. The Bucks getting their last shot to go. Out to the right wing. Outside Milton. Harrell the screen. Milton passes to Harrell. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Harrell. Melton, he's checked in for House. Bobby Portis has checked in for Milwaukee. Connaughton comes in for Carter. Close game here in Philadelphia. 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Pass to Nora. Antetokounmpo up top. He's got 21.
Well, I tell you what, the long arms of Antetokounmpo are really incredibly lethal in the paint. Sometimes the defense really has no choice but to foul him and then hope he misses.
It's tied up with that one. Now they lead as the free throw drops in for them. For Philadelphia, they've gotten 8 of 14 shots to drop so far in the second. Here's Milton. And that makes him 3 for 4. He's looking good.
What a move, showing off the handles there.
Antetokounmpo inside. Niang's there. Shot's good by Antetokounmpo.
From role player to MVP, Giannis is improving his upper body strength. Has really been a factor in his overall development.
And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. The Bucks on top, they're up by 1. And we'll be right back after halftime for the start of the third quarter. See you in just a bit.
Welcome. First up, let's look at the two guys who are each leading their respective teams through the first half.
They've been assertive at the offensive end, willing and able to shoulder the scoring for their teams.
Yeah, they put on a show for us, Shaq. You know, it's something we kind of expected, but two great competitors are really going at it.
And a look back now at the first half, as the Sixers have a tight game on their hands.
They've gotten a big lift from their bench, the others making their presence felt at the offensive end. Nice work.
If you're the coach, it's great to have those options at your disposal, and he's taking advantage of it.
Thanks for tuning in. Now it's time to head back over to Brian Anderson for the start of the third quarter.
Second half of basketball is upon us, and we may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game we've seen so far. It's been a clinic out there by Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Yeah, he's showing off how skilled he is at attacking the defense and converting at the line.
Well, you know, in that first half, it was a common occurrence. He got to the stripe time and time again.
And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during halftime. Up front, it's Tucker at the four, next to Embiid in the middle. Tyrese Maxey is out there with Matisse Thybulle. And it's Harris in at the three. That's Doc Rivers' five as we get into the second half.
You know, I know Giannis would rather get inside, but he's got the touch to make the mid-range shot, and he needs to take it when it's available.
Embiid inside, covered by Lopez. And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
Thanks, Brian. James Harden, with plenty of confidence, said, "Not to brag or anything, but I'm really good at this game. I'm unselfish. I play the right way. I don't try to do anything I can't do or that doesn't benefit our team. And that mindset keeps me in a good place." B.A.?
Very self-assured, Allie. Thank you. Shots good by Antetokounmpo.
We've seen that more than once today. An effortless basket inside.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Now here's Maxey. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. Pass to Embiid. Just five to shoot. And it's good. Off the back rim and in.
You know, with all he does offensively, at his size, Joel Embiid is like a cheat code, a special talent.
Holiday finds Antetokounmpo. And here's Allen. Fires the three. Pure from three-point range. Allen's got six.
Excellent execution coming out of the break. They've taken three shots and made three shots.
Now Maxey to the middle. Here's Harris. Uses the glass on the layup. 9 points in the game.
Harris has really become much more adept at finishing hard shots. Great focus there.
And the improvement of Tyrese Maxey's three-point shot from his first season to second year, just unprecedented. He improved by over 12% with a huge increase in attempts as well.
Here's Maxey. And the 76ers call time here. And for a player with the speed and quickness of Maxey, Grant, leveling up that three-point shot changes everything for him.
Oh, so true, B.A. It becomes pick your poison with him. And it put him in a conversation last year for most improved player.
Now that we're into November, let's see how the Eastern Conference standings are shaken out. You take a look at the Bucks in second now, but wanting to claim that top seed. And of course, there's Philadelphia, now four games behind.
Seeing where the Bucks are, you have to really give it to them. I mean, they are backing up all the preseason hype. They've been outstanding early.
It appears to me, though, that this group has all the ingredients for a special season.
And here are the Sixers now. Thybulle passes to Maxey. Stolen by Carter. Oh, and a fast break for the Bucks. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket is good, and he'll go to the line.
I just love the ball movement.
And that one misses. The 76ers have got 2 of 3 from the floor in this third quarter. Back to Maxey. Pass to Tucker. Embiid against Lopez. It's good. Embiid's got 19 points.
Well, I like this execution coming out of the half. Solid. 3 for 4 from the field so far.
Antetokounmpo finds Lopez. Now here's Holiday. And here is Antetokounmpo. Checked by Tucker. Antetokounmpo can't connect. For Philadelphia, they've gotten 3 of 4 shots to fall so far in the third. Outside Maxey. Pass to Tucker. Over Antetokounmpo. Antetokounmpo with the block. All right, let's take a look at the leaderboard and see the small forwards who have been picking the most pockets this season. Third is Tobias Harris.
And if you're an opposing small forward, this might also double as a list of the most irritating players in the league. Because when you tackle them head-to-head, it's on.
They are an elite group of defenders. I mean, they don't just make it difficult for opposing small forwards. They pester entire teams with their activity, jumping in the passing lanes, being active with their hands and feet. Very impressive defensively.
And the Bucks with some changes. Ibaka comes in for Lopez. And it's Hill in for Carter. That one falls, so he hits both of them. Milwaukee has gone 2 for 2 from deep here in the third. Hill, the pass to Allen from behind the arc. It's hauled in by the Sixers. Embiid's got rebound number 8 now. Hill against Maxey. Here's Embiid. Ooh, hits the difficult fadeaway jumper. Embiid's got 21.
And there's some nice chemistry on offense. They're just taking what the defense allows.
Well, it's interesting. The defense continues to back off, expecting them to attack the rack. But they just continue to pull up and knock down those mid-range jumpers.
House, he's checked in for the Sixers. Matthews, he's checked in for the Bucks. The 76ers have gone 4 of 6 from the floor in this third quarter. Maxey against Hill. Maxey passes to Harris. And another miss by Philadelphia. For Milwaukee, they've gotten 5 of 7 attempts in the third quarter. Outside, Hill. Pass to Holiday. And he floats it in for the easy 2. Credit the sweet setup on that one.
That's been typical of their performance today. They're sharing the ball and creating good shots.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
And Philadelphia has possession. After the Bucks picking up a basket just moments ago. Back to Maxey. And he's going to the line for 2. The official saw contact while he was going up.
Hey, if you can't block it, sending him to the line can be the next best thing.
Yeah, exactly. Prevent the layup, give him a little bump, and then maybe they'll think twice about coming into the lane next time. And if they don't think about it, at least they might be distracted by your presence.
That free throw's good from Maxey. And some changes here for the 76ers. Harrell's checked in for Joel Embiid. Korkmaz comes in for Tobias Harris. And it's Melton in for Thybulle. Portis, he's checked in for the Bucks. Connaughton comes in for Jrue Holiday. He's perfect from the line this time.
And we've seen some good free throw shooting in the second half.
Yeah, you know what? And I think they've just got to keep on keeping on. Keep drawing contact, attacking, getting to the line. That will certainly give them a chance to get back into the game.
Now here's Portis. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Shot clock at 6. Oh, they get a hand on it. And stolen by Melton. Pass to Maxey. Shoots over Portis. Deflected! Here's Matthews. Portis. The pass to Connaughton. Here's Ibaka. Poked loose. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws.
You know, in Ibaka's case, his explosiveness turned into reliability. Entering the league, he was really a raw athlete. Now he's a polished, consistent, and willing mentor to the younger guys. That's valuable on a championship-caliber team.
And he makes a first, and Ibaka helps set the table for a trend. Bigs who can protect the rim and stretch the floor, Clark.
And you know, B.A., those types of guys are getting drafted higher than ever. They bring great value with the versatility that they offer at both ends of the floor. They're getting big money in free agency, too. It's a good time to be a stretch big. I wish I could go back to the future and cash in on some of that cheese.
The Sixers trailing. Here's Korkmaz. Shoots over Hill. The Sixers with another miss. Here's Nora. Looking for his first basket still in this one. Hill finds Portis. Connaughton outside. Out left to the wing. Six on the shot clock. Inside. And it's going to be a 3-second call.
First an opponent shooting percentage. And their ranking and lowest opponent scoring is second in the league. Their defense is more than an asset. It's a weapon.
And they are number one in rebounding for a reason. They pound the glass with aggression, and they attack the boards with a fearlessness. Milton's checked in for the Sixers. For Philadelphia, they've gone 4 of 9 in the third quarter. Melton outside. Harrell, a screen on Hill. Shot from 12. Melton, no good. The Bucks have gotten 6 of 8 shots to go and looking good since the break. Pass to Hill. And here's Portis. Ibaka, the pass to Connaughton. To the wing, right side. Now here's Portis. The teardrop. And it's Niang with the rebound. Philadelphia shooting 40% since the break. There's 1:17 left in the third quarter. For three, Harrell. The Sixers again can't hit. Milwaukee in the lead. And here is Hill. Right now averaging 5.5 a game. Pass to Nora. Now here's Connaughton. Hill for three. Gets the three to fall. Hill's got 5.
This is what it's been since halftime. Remarkable results from downtown.
Boy, it's been a 3-point barrage. They came out gunning and have not stopped.
They need something good to happen here.
Yeah, they've gone way too long without a score.
Hill against Milton. And Harrell with the strong finish.
The alley-oop throwdown by Harrell right there, emphatically. And he fires up his teammates as well.
Milwaukee has gone 3 of 4 from outside in the second half. Ibaka with a screen on Milton. Milton against Hill. Pass to Ibaka. Cranked it in off the glass.
You know, in that first half, a lot more three-point shooting. Since then, though, they've dialed it back.
Harrell with it. Korkmaz on the wing. Milton with it. Launches a three. Hits a three-pointer. He's got 9. The third quarter comes to a close. The Bucks on top. They lead by 4. After a quick break, we're coming right back with the start of the fourth quarter. And now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
You have to love his unselfishness and ability to make those around him better.
Well, clearly he's the guy that stirs the drink for him, and that's how he does it, with his dynamite passing skills.
We've reached the fourth quarter in what has been a very competitive game. Should be an exciting finish. Taking a look at the Bucks. Holiday and Connaughton are in at guard. Giannis and Lopez are the bigs. And it's Allen in at the three.
And over time, as his game has evolved, Harris has accepted a bigger, expanded role. Knows he has the green light.
Now here's Connaughton. Pass to Holiday. Here's Lopez. And there's the screen. Antetokounmpo for three. Drains the triple. Antetokounmpo has got 32 points in the game.
He's certainly been their go-to guy when it matters most. He's trying to close this one out.
Outside Maxey. Harris, a screen on Holiday. Here's Maxey. And that one drops.
And you want him taking good shots at this point in the game. And that one was easy.
Well, you don't want to give him any open shots at this stage. Never mind a layup. Come on now. My goodness.
Outstanding dribble drive. And that replay was brought to you by Mobile One.
Whoa, a drive like that is the kind of play that can shift the entire outcome of a close game like this one.
Count the basket.
All game long, he's been getting to his spots. And the defense has yet to adjust.
Philadelphia has gone 3 of 6 from deep so far. Outside Maxey. Harris, a screen on Holiday. Maxey attacking. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
And this is just typical of him. Always making an impact at crucial moments in the game.
You know, they want the ball in his hands here because they trust him to hit all the big shots.
Holiday against Maxey. Holiday passes to Antetokounmpo. That one falls. Nice feed that time from Holiday. Holiday's got 6 assists now in the game. The 76ers have gone a perfect 3 for 3 here in the fourth. Maxey against Holiday. Now here's Embiid. The D's right on him. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And that's a foul called on Pat Connaughton. That's his first foul of the game. Carter, he's checked in for Connaughton. Outside Tucker. Pass to Melton. Shot clock at 5. Goes up from the top of the key. And it comes off the front of the rim. Milwaukee has got 6 out of 15 threes so far in this game. Antetokounmpo inside. Maxey covering. Antetokounmpo! Bam!
He's been perfect this quarter. They keep feeding him, and he keeps delivering.
Holiday against Maxey. And Harris throws it down.
You know, sometimes it's that simple. Just get it up in the air and let Harris do the rest of the work.
Antetokounmpo with it. And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth now. And Embiid with the block. Carter with it. Picked up by Tucker. Carter, good.
Great timing and coordination. Lays it in coming off that pick.
For Philadelphia, they've gotten 4 of 5 attempts to fall so far in the fourth. Outside Maxey. Embiid inside. Working on Lopez. Embiid can't hit. The Bucks have gotten 5 of 6 shots to go in the fourth. Antetokounmpo against Harris. Antetokounmpo, bam! Antetokounmpo has got 40 points.
They're finding ways to get the ball into the paint. 5 consecutive buckets.
And on the flip side, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
Now here's Tucker. To the inside. Here's Harris. Oh, it's blocked by Lopez. Antetokounmpo outside. Outside Carter. Back to Antetokounmpo. Pass to Allen. Fires for three. And the Bucks hit again from deep.
Improving as a playmaker, Giannis knows this is the next step in him becoming an even greater player.
Time called here. The 76ers decide to talk it over. Let's check in with our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Hey guys, during that last break, I heard Doc Rivers as he talked with the team. It wasn't feel-good pep talk. He wants them to show some fight in the closing moments. He told them, if you guys want to salvage any respect from this game, now's the time to do it. Show them we are better than this. Guys, take it away.
And Allie, thank you for that. Here's Maxey. They've got plenty of time to get back into this.
Yeah, I'm sure they feel pressed, but this is when you have to stay calm and execute. What's the rule?
Pass to Embiid. Whistle blows. Yep, that's going to be a travel.
Just his first turnover of the night. He's been poised and he's been focused.
And that's how you defend. Glad we had a chance to see a replay of that block again.
Oh, amazing indeed. And getting stops like that only encourages them to keep attacking on the offensive end.
Here's Antetokounmpo. Hey, and out of bounds, the 76ers will take it. Here's Maxey. Pass to Tucker, to the paint. Lopez against Embiid. Shoots over Lopez. Oh, and just miss after miss right now. Milwaukee has got 7 of their 16 three-point attempts to go in. Back to Antetokounmpo. Inside, tipped. Holiday against Maxey. And a bit of a battle for the ball. And the officials signal a jump ball here. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Holiday finds Lopez. And he lobs it up top! And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Lopez.
You know, I think he may have forced that pass when there was really no reason to.
Philadelphia has gone 3 of 6 from deep so far. Holiday against Maxey. Now here's Embiid, guarded closely. Harris against Allen. The 3 is up. And Tucker gets it to go.
You know, when you're guarding Tucker, you've got to account for his jump shot. I mean, if you don't, he'll bite you.
Here's Antetokounmpo. it's blocked by Embiid. 1:52 left in the fourth quarter. Melton with a screen on Holiday. Embiid inside. Covered by Lopez. Embiid misses. Milwaukee has gone 2 of 2 from outside so far in the fourth. Pass to Lopez. Here's Antetokounmpo. Takes the 12-footer and hits it. Antetokounmpo's got 42 in the game.
Set him up well there. Brook Lopez showing his vision and willingness as a passer.
1:27 left in the fourth quarter. To the middle. Here's Embiid. Oh, he nails it. 10 for 14 after that one.
And his fantastic performance from the last game has carried over to tonight.
And you know that's how it goes with him. I mean, his hot streaks, guys, don't last minutes. They last days.
And we've got 1:18 left in the fourth quarter of this one. And Antetokounmpo, here we go.
I tell you what, it's absolutely foolish and futile to let Antetokounmpo get space to sprint towards the rim. I mean, the dunks he jams home are just downright filthy, ugly, nasty, wicked.
Out to the wing. Lopez against Embiid. Rejected by Lopez.
Nothing left to do but to watch the clock tick towards zero. Nice victory here for the Bucks.
Offensively, they made the most of their trips.
They found multiple ways to score consistently, and a little luck doesn't hurt them either. They also got some nice bounces off the rim tonight, too.
And this win will give them 12 on the year thus far. And what a huge performance it was for Giannis Antetokounmpo.
A quality offensive outing. When you get it going like he did, I'll tell you, it's one of the best feelings in basketball.
Now here's Maxey. Now here's Embiid. Again, the Sixers score.
Strong performance from him, but he may need to do even more if they're going to win this game.
About 3 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. Carter, the pass to Antetokounmpo. And here's Holiday.
Get to the block, Brooke.
Carter finds Antetokounmpo. Back to Carter. 4 on the clock. Shoots over Melton. And that one hits the back iron. And so it's Milwaukee easily grabbing this one. Exceptional effort on the road. They were ready and they were focused.
Focused indeed. I mean, it takes a strong mental approach to block out the distractions. These guys stepped up 100%.
All right, let's go courtside to Ali LaForce with our player of the game. Ali, it's all yours.
Giannis, you dominated the game offensively. What were you seeing out there?
You know, I just want to thank my teammates that they put me in spot to help me be successful. And we just played hard. I'm happy that we got the win.
Full team win out there tonight. Thanks so much.
Ali, thank you as always. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Grant Hill, Clark Kellogg, and Ali LaForce, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching. Last but not least, here is your New Balance player of the game, Giannis Antetokounmpo.